I want to go straight to the point. We are here discussing emotional intelligence. Emotions have a source. Emotions are not just mere expressions that come out of nowhere. Emotions come out of what we call sensory data. And the sensory data within every human being is made up of two components. The first one is traits, where they are involuntary because you were born with them. You see that sometimes someone's father likes shouting. Then they give it to a child, and the child naturally likes shouting. Are we together?
Yes.
That is the trend where emotional intelligence comes as a result of, where emotions come as a result of traits. Then the second aspect of it is where emotions are born out of information we have intentionally stored on our mind. I want us to do a simple exercise, just to take off the stress, and then we'll continue. I do it often. So, spell the word knowledge for me, and let's go. Knowledge.
K-N-O-W-L-E-G-G-E.
Knowledge. I like the children. When I say you should spell the word, they pronounce the word, they spelled it, and after that, they pronounce it again. That's the correct way to go about it. Now, I want you to look at the word you have spelled and take an imaginary pencil and divide the word into two through the air. You have one word to your left and another word to your right. What word do you have to your left?
No.
And what word do you have to your right?
Edge.
What you know is what gives you an edge in life. Are you here with me? I want us to do another exercise. I'll explain the two and then I'll quickly build on what I'm going to do. And I'll ask for sure because I have another serious meeting elsewhere today. Let's spell the word learn.
Yeah.
Let's spell the word learn.
Yeah.
No, 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 we pronounce the word first.
Yeah.
Let's spell the word learn. Erase the L. What do you have?
Hey.
You realize that your earning is in your learning?
Yes.
Hello?
Hi.
We have a principal problem in our country. And I just want to just scratch the surface because of time and I'll leave. And Nana, the problem has got to do with the way we practice Christianity in Ghana and in Africa. I can tell you on authority, as a theologian, that Christianity in Ghana and in Africa has contributed immensely to our backwardness. Proverbs chapter 19 verse 2 says that zeal without knowledge is not good, and to be hasty and miss the way. In Romans 10, 1 and 2, Paul says that my heart's desire and prayer for Israel is that they should be saved. But I bear the record that even though they have a zeal for God, their zeal is without knowledge. And so in Ghana, you see a lot of seriousness when it comes to religious activities, but there is no proper features or demonstrations of knowledge and intelligence in the way we go about our practice of Christian spirituality. That is why you find a Christian who prays and wants to be like David, who was a king, who ruled in their affairs, but would not want to have anything to do with you because they have been deceitfully oriented to think that our traditional leaders are idol worshippers and evil people that we must not submit to, that we must not obey. And yet the same people who read about David and hear him forgetting that David was as much a king as you are. And David was also cutting the head of animals like goat, like sheep, like cattle to offer as offerings. It's another subject we have at another time. That is why we are backward in our country. Because the Christian feels that if he does not pay tithe, he is not going to be blessed by God. So this same Christian who is concerned about paying tithe in church wants to use creative and cunning means to elude paying of taxes. So whenever our budgets are drawn, we have budget deficits because we cannot generate enough revenue from our taxes to meet our existential needs. Then what do our governments, our leaders do? They go and borrow money. They are unable to construct our roads, and we serve. And the Christian goes to church to pray when you need to go and work. A lot of Christians have been misled because of the way the Bible is being integrated, or rather misinterpreted. And I don't have enough time. Otherwise, we will delve into a lot of things. And let me ask you a simple question. How many of you are Christians here? How many of you are Christians here? Okay. A simple question, I'll answer it and then I will leave. With what was the wall of Jericho broken down? Hello? What? I can't hear you. Shouting. Yeah. You see? Listen very carefully. Any preacher who has ever told you that the wall of Jericho was broken with a shout has played on your intelligence. They have actually played on your intelligence and by using your emotions, because a lot of Christians are not emotionally intelligent. Once we get into chapels, we put our brains on break, begin to worship men, and when they teach anything, we don't go back. Like we find in Acts chapter 17, verse 11, the beloved Christians who will check the scriptures to find out whether what is being taught is so wrong. So let me just end with this scripture. How many times did the Israelites go around the world of Jericho?
Seven times.
Hello?
Seven times.
You see, I'm asking all these questions, I'm getting all the wrong answers because we have all kinds of pastors who are only interested in social and material aggrandizement. They want to show how they are rich and wealthy, and they don't pay attention. So I just mentioned this once financially, and then I will spend one thing and go. See, there were a number of things that the angel of the Lord who appeared to Joshua told him to do regarding Jericho. He should go with all the men of war. The priests should sanctify themselves. He should go with the ark. He should go with the ark of the Lord. He says that the men of war should go. The priests, some should bear trumpets, some should bear ram's horses. And those bearing the ram's horses and the trumpets should go ahead of the ark of the Lord. And each day, this is very important, each day, for the first 6 days, they should go around the wall once. On the seventh day, they should go around the wall 7 times. They went around the wall 13 times, not 7 times. Simple mathematics about a common scripture Christians don't do. Are you with me? That is it. Now, Nana, in the incident of Jericho, they observed more silence than wisdom. And if we are going to be emotionally intelligent, we must learn the value of silence in living responsible lives. They observed more silence than wisdom. And the Lord said that. After the seventh round on the seventh day, the priest should blow the trumpet. Then those who are carrying the ram's horses should also blow the ram's horses. Then the people should shout. Then the walls will come down. The Bible never said that the shout was was going to bring down the walls.
Okay.
And I was explaining it to him. And the pastor was saying, if the people had shouted on the first day, the walls have come down. Why? Why? Good. So that wasn't the instruction. And so if you want to find what it is that led to the breaking of the wall, you must ask yourself, what was the instruction? What it means is that it was not their shout that was going to break down the wall. But God was the one who broke down the wall in response to their obedience to the commands of God. They shout. They make noise. So you go to church and you make noise. You are screaming. When you have to deal with the situation, you are praying that God will come and do for you what He has given you ability to do, because somebody has disoriented you and you are not emotionally intelligent. That is why in Ghana and in Africa, we think that our ancestors are evil. And there are ancestral cases we need to be breaking every day. In January, we organize water against water and pray against the waters. It seems they don't break. So in February, we organize another one against which is the one day, if you go to rest, your great girl's child, if they are not properly taught, will come and say that there was something you did that has brought a certain case on today. That is why you are not progressing. I have a problem. The white man who came to Ghana and other parts of Africa bought human beings in exchange, or took human beings away in exchange for alcohol, who will cut the stomach of pregnant women, take the babies out, who will throw sand into the sea because he thinks they are weak, they cannot go away. Then their ancestors have not done anything evil. That is not a curse upon them, which they must be breaking every day. It is we, the Africans, who will not break it. It is our ancestors who have done something that every day we want to break. So we are not emotionally intelligent. We are not emotionally intelligent, even at best of Christianity. And because of that, pastors are taking advantage of you. Even when your mother is sick, instead of taking care of your mother, you want to go and give offering because you are not thinking for your mother to die. Another time.